Picture a hilltop and two individuals on that hill. They see the beauty of God's creation. They see a brother and sister helping one another. They see a couple kissing and holding hands. That will end. They see the sunrise. They see from the hand of God the Father all kinds of beautiful and self-giving things that are killing creation. They see someone caring for a little one that can't care for themselves. They see a church care for brothers who have made a series of terrible decisions and they need help. And so as brothers and sisters, they open up their doors and provide for them. They see other brothers and sisters feeding, neighbors, sharing with them clothing, food, themselves. They see a number of singers going out into the community and sharing praises for the sake of saying thank you, God. They're on this hilltop, and they see all these beautiful and wonderful and glorious things filling God's creation. And these things are led and directed by the very presence and hand of God. And these things are growing fruit. Like in that Galatians text, good fruit. It's growing more good stuff. Nothing can shake us. Because God is so good. Yes, things get mixed up and turn around. Because God is closer. God is ever more present than the things which challenge us. I have to give a shout out to my brothers and sisters in West Virginia. Houses are floating away, people are dying. And how seriously shaken we become because there is great destruction. And they take us to the flesh. We are flesh. We cannot deny our sin. We cannot deny that we're less than perfect. Because we're bearing the proof that we're not. Cut us and we'll bleed. So nobody measures up to being pure and perfect. We all fail. If there's one who doesn't fit. And Jesus Christ is taking on our flesh, and he's joined us, and he calls us to follow. Now in that gospel text, we hear that there's a word of repentance. He rebukes. Whom does he rebuke? Look at that text. He rebukes them. Now some of us might assume it's the Samaritans that should be rebuked. But I remember this Samaritan, don't you? Maybe it was John and James being rebuked. That also would make sense. You know you deserve to be rebuked. I know I deserve to be rebuked because of our flesh. And yet it doesn't stop us. Doesn't prevent us. The rebuke doesn't prevent us from following Jesus Christ. All of us are worthy of right. And out of pride, or whatever risk on that other side, the fleshly side, we'll pick one of those and we'll take it to the hill with us. But a brother or sister who truly loves me will rebuke me. He'll speak a word that I need to hear that'll correct me. And if I truly love and care for you, a brother or sister, I will speak a word that will seem harsh to you. And it might tear you down. And it'll hurt. So this idea of rebuking one another in fellowship,
keep going,
and brothers and sisters that haven't sung yet, You're not fit for the kingdom of God. We have to go. And we have to keep going. And the Lord will breathe into us some of the ways that we're affected, but on a new day. On today. On tomorrow. On the next day. And we'll keep going. And we'll keep going. And the flesh will take our last breath away from us, but we'll keep going. With a new body. In a new way, we're playing the word. We're rebuked. Take it like kingdom. Take it like radiation. We need it. Kill those things that are killing me. Take that rebuke. And then go. And keep going. As brothers and sisters, bound together in Christ Jesus, it's what we have to do. Now go back to that hilltop of those two people overlooking God's creation and pan back. No, they're not in tubs looking at the sunset. That's the sinful nature of you, right? I know you were looking for it. No, those two individuals pan back. They're upon the cross of Jesus Christ. And that's how they saw. That's how we see. That's how we know and come to believe that there are so many beautiful and wonderful things happening in this God's creation. Because we're standing upon what Christ has done for us. His death and resurrection give us a means of standing. To go and proclaim, to be filled with new life and vigor. We're standing upon the merits. Upon the very cross on Calvary, that's the hill of Jesus Christ. And we thank you for sending us and making this kingdom bound. We will not be. With your leadership, Lord, take us where we're standing and we're crossing Calvary.